Hey, James here from Larry's Club. Like I promised, I'm here with our first lesson outcome video, lesson outcome number one. I get it, and this is tip number 102. I want to tell you a little bit about why this lesson outcome occurs today, and then I'm going to explain how you can transition your child from this lesson outcome to the next lesson in order to keep the momentum going in their learning. Now, this lesson outcome occurs when a child has gone through, understands the activity, but wants to move on. The reason this occurs is the child has gotten good enough at this lesson, but the lesson doesn't match their unique learning style. An example of this would be if your child is mostly a kinesthetic learner, but the lesson contains mostly visual or auditory methods. So it doesn't match their learning style, and therefore they want to move on. Now, the important thing to remember is to not drill the lesson at this point because it will most likely frustrate or bore your child. The way you can transition them from after they've gotten it, they understand the lesson, is to ask them if they think it's time to move on to the next lesson. Now, what you'll notice is you'll have about 5 or 10 lessons that'll follow the exact same pattern as I get it, but then they'll run into one lesson that they get and they really want to go through again and again. That means your child has, their style of learning has matched the lesson itself, and that's the topic of next week's video. Next week I'm going to talk about what the lesson outcome is where your child gets the activity and wants to do it again and again, as well as how you can help them transition. And we call this lesson one more time, just like the Britney Spears lyric, "Hit me, baby, one more time." Anybody? No? Okay. Well, if you have any questions about the first lesson outcome, go ahead and leave a comment below. Larry or Antoinette will get back to you within about 48 hours. And thank you so much. Look forward to talking to you next week. See ya.